Say, devotion elves.
Devotion, elves, and Santas. In case you're wearing a Santa hat or elves.
Ready to share God's word together today.
Just like sharing presents for real elves.
God's word is a present to us each day as God dwells through each of us. Say good morning, Karen.
Good morning, Carrot.
All right. We have a long story to share this morning. So why don't you go ahead and start us with prayer, Addie?
Got good for rolling and bare
Bare
toes
toes.
and bare toes. The green grass grows and grows. Thank you, God, for this fine treat. Soft and crushy beneath my feet. Amen.
It's cushy.
Cushy.
Say good morning,
Good morning,
Karen. All right.
Karen. Again.
Yeah, two Karens. Soft and cushy is a prayer for grass this morning. Addie has an ex spent a lot of time with grass, outside of the park. So we'll forgive her for that, of course. Judges. If you find your way to the book of Judges, we'll spend some time with a story, like 20 verses. So let's get going here. So it's after Joshua, early in the Old Testament, right after the Pentateuch, those first five books of the Bible. We'll spend some time here in this story in chapter 13 of Judges. We'll start in the second verse. If you got it there and want to read along, we will spend this time dwelling together in God's word. There was a certain man of Zorah, of the tribe of the Danites, whose name was Manoah. His wife was barren, having borne no children. And the angel of the Lord appeared to the woman and said to her, "Although you are barren, having borne no children, you shall conceive and bear a son. Now be careful not to drink wine or strong drink, or to eat anything unclean, for you shall conceive and bear a son. No razor is to come to his head, for the boy shall be a Nazarite to God from birth. It is he who shall begin to deliver Israel from the hand of the Philistines." Then the woman came and told her husband, "A man of God came to me, and his appearance was like that of an angel of God, most awe-inspiring. I did not ask him where he came from, and he did not tell me his name. But he said to me, 'You shall conceive and bear a son. So then drink no wine or strong drink, and eat nothing unclean, for the boy shall be a Nazarite to God from birth to the day of his death.' Then Manoah entreated the Lord and said, 'O Lord, I pray, let the man of God whom you sent come to us again and teach us what we are to do concerning the boy who will be born.' God listened to Manoah, and the angel of God came again to the woman as she sat in the field, but her husband Manoah was not with her. So the woman ran quickly and told her husband, 'The man who came to me the other day has appeared to me.' Manoah got up and followed his wife and came to the man and said to him, 'Are you the man who spoke to this woman?' And he said, 'I am.' Then Manoah said, 'Now, when your words come true, what is to be the boy's rule of life? What is he to do?' The angel of the Lord said to Manoah, 'Let the woman give heed to all that I said to her. She may not eat of anything that comes from the vine. She is not to drink wine or strong drink or eat any unclean thing. She is to observe everything that I commanded her.' Manoah said to the angel of the Lord, 'Allow us to detain you and prepare a kid for you.' The angel of the Lord said to Manoah, 'If you detain me, I will not eat your food. But if you want to prepare a burnt offering, then offer it to the Lord.' For Manoah did not know that he was the angel of the Lord. Then Manoah said to the angel of the Lord, 'What is your name, so that we may honor you when your words come true?' But the angel of the Lord said to him, 'Why do you ask my name? It is too wonderful.' So Manoah took the kid with the grain offering and offered it on the rock to the Lord, to him who works wonders. When the flame went up toward heaven from the altar, the angel of the Lord ascended in the flame of the altar while Manoah and his wife looked on, and they fell on their faces to the ground. The angel of the Lord did not appear again to Manoah and his wife. Then Manoah realized it, and that it was the angel of the Lord. And Manoah said to his wife, "We shall surely die, for we have seen God." But his wife said to him, "If the Lord had meant to kill us, he would not have accepted a burnt offering and a grain offering at our hands, or shown us all these things, or now announced to us such things as these." The woman bore a son and named him Samson. The boy grew, and the Lord blessed him. Thanks for sharing this story from Judges together. We have a devotion now from Christ in Our Home entitled Vessels of God's Promise, inviting our focus to verse 24, "And the Lord blessed him." Quite like the Elizabeth and Mary stories in Luke, an angel here makes a promise to an unnamed woman whose husband is then skeptical of her report. I'm sure you probably heard those parallels in our reading here today, friends. Can it be that she will be a vessel to carry a son with a special God-appointed role? As will later take place with Zechariah and Joseph, the angel verifies the news for the sake of the husband. This birth announcement comes with a handbook for this particular baby's prenatal care, early childhood, and beyond, for he will be a Nazarite, set apart in special ways as holy to the Lord. And no poring through books of names for these parents, God has provided the name, Samson. God's call comes to us in various and sometimes mysterious ways, through the Bible, a faith mentor or spiritual director, or some formative event. Hindsight, as they say, is 20/20. Take time this Advent to look back on how you have been blessed by God and called to be a vessel carrying God's promises to the world. An invitation to pray this morning. God, we hear you calling, but sometimes other voices drown out your message. Help us listen. Amen. And then as this day unfolds before you, dear friends, be invited to pray for people longing to be parents. We'll be in prayer together as we continue on this journey together through life and faith. We look forward to connecting in worship together here at 9 o'clock on our Facebook page, on our website, and our YouTube channel as we spend time worshiping our seventh and final Sunday of our Advent journey. And then we look forward to Christmas Eve next Thursday at 6 o'clock on all our digital channels as well as we continue to share this journey together in life and faith, dear friends. May God bless you this morning as we share morning greetings. I see Margie and Pastor Heike. I think Dee Gutierrez, see on there as well from earlier. God bless you all. Have a wonderful day, and we'll continue to share this journey to sustain one another in and with God's Word.